Give it up for Steve Harvey.
How y'all doing? Welcome to the show. Thank y'all. I appreciate it. How y'all doing? Thank y'all. Thank you very much. I appreciate that. Thank y'all. Thank you very much. I appreciate y'all. Thank you very much. Well, welcome to Family Feud, South Africa style. I'm your man, Steve Harvey, yeah. Well, we got a good one for you today. Looking forward to sharing some laughs with y'all today. We having a good time here in Africa, man. Now, this is how it's gonna work, folks. Our researchers have been out on the streets of Mzansi. Yeah. They have been asking you for answers to some very, very simple questions. The answers to those questions are locked into our game board up here. All these families have to do is match up those answers. Whoever gets the most points is gonna walk away from here with some serious money today. Yes! All right, here we go. From Firinanging. I guess that wasn't it. Where y'all from?
Vereniging.
Huh?
Vereniging.
For what?
Let's do it together, Steve.
Vereniging.
From Vereniging, it's the Lambert family. Here we go now, though. From Dobbinsonville. In Soweto. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, man. It's the Rastafari family.
You got it, yeah.
All I know is I saw Soweto.
Soweto.
Yeah. Everybody's here for a chance to win some cash, and somebody's gonna have a shot at winning the grand jackpot of 75,000 rand. You ready for the show to get started? Everybody say, let's get it on.
Let's get it on.
Give me Fuad, give me Refiwe. All right, say your name.
Fuad.
Fuad, I had it.
Yeah, you got it.
Refiwe.
Refiwe, good, here we go. All right, top seven answers on the board, here we go. We asked 100 men. Name something women lie about.
Their affairs.
Their affairs. Their affairs. Oh.
The amount of money they spend.
Yes! My wife!
Me too.
Marjorie!
They're gonna play, Steve.
They're gonna play. Yes. Rafiwe, what do you do for a living?
I'm a logistics manager.
A logistics manager?
Yes.
That's good. All right, introduce everybody.
Okay, Steve, so this is my family in love. We have Tato. She's my niece. We have Kamo, my niece, Gugu, my niece, and Dumelo, my brother-in-law.
Yeah. Right. Well, let's go. Tato.
Yes.
What do you do?
I am a corporate communication student.
Oh, that's good. That's good. So when you graduate, you hope to get a job as what?
Hopefully a communications practitioner, because I'll be qualified as a PR practitioner.
A PR practitioner?
Yes.
Oh, public relations. I have PR people.
Mm. I'll slide in my CV.
Slide in your what?
My CV.
Your CV.
Yes.
Oh, I know what that is, cousin. No, hold on, wait. This was one of the questions. The CV is a, don't say nothing, I got it. CV, like a resume.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. I am learning the culture.
Yeah.
CV in the States, nothing. We don't have that. All right, let's go, Tato. Talk to 100 men, name something women lie about.
Their age.
All the time. Their age.
Yes.
Come on.
Hey, Steve.
said, hey, Kamo, what do you do?
I work in marketing, but I studied politics.
You studied politics?
I studied politics.
We're having problems in the United States with our politics.
I'll come work.
You'll come work there?
Well, he won't.
Well, hopefully he won't be in the president long. We asked 100 men, name something women lie about.
The size of their waist clothes. They say I'm a size small when they're actually large.
Oh, so we're finding out some new stuff. Walking around lying about your size. I'm an 8. You a 14. About your size.
Yeah.
I'm just gonna go with Google.
Yes.
Like a heartbeat.
Huh?
Like a heartbeat. Goo-goo.
It really is the simplest way that I could explain it.
Google?
Yes.
What relation are you to Refilwe?
So Fifi is married to my uncle. So she's our makoti. So in South Africa, ke makoti.
She got your coat.
Goat.
Meaning bride.
Your goat? What are you saying?
That's a word.
Ma.
Ma.
Ko.
Ma ko.
Ti.
Ma goti.
Ma goti.
Ma koti.
Yes, meaning bride in Setswana.
In Setswana, mekote.
Ma goti.
Ma koti.
Yes.
Is a bride.
Yes.
Ah, this is so educational for me. Okay. We asked 100 men. Name something women lie about.
Their salary, how much they earn.
Yes.
Good answer. Their husband.
Their salary.
Oh. Okay. I tried.
Tumelo?
Yes. You got it.
What do you do for a living?
I work at MIN at the fire department under fire prevention.
You a fireman?
No. Admin, like administration at the fire department.
Oh, at the administration.
Yeah,
oh,
so okay. I don't do the actual...
Yeah, no.
Not for me, yeah.
Not for you?
Not for me, sir.
Yeah, me either, I can't. Mm. We talked to 100 men. Name something that women lie about.
I have to go with their shoe size.
That's really true. Oh, if somebody asks you, you lie. But when you go to the store, you have to tell the truth. Shoe size. Oh. All right, now we got 2 strikes now. Come on, ladies, let's go. We talked to 100 men, named something women lie about.
Their hair.
Huh? Yeah. They lie about their hair.
Their hair.
Yeah. Their hair.
Oh.
We asked 100 men, name something women lie about.
Well, my wife lies about it, so we're gonna go with their feelings.
Their feelings? Now, Fuad.
Yes.
Is your wife here?
Right next to me.
Steve, wow. You know, I'm fine doesn't mean I'm fine.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
What's wrong? Nothing.
Nothing.
Yeah, baby, how you doing? I'm fine.
Yeah.
Yes. What's wrong? Nothing.
Yes.
If they say nothing's wrong, everything's wrong. Their feelings. That's really a good answer, though. Oh, but I know a lot more than that. Let's go. Number seven. I knew when they flipped it over and they said Big O, I said, I don't think this audience quite gets that. Number six. Five. One. Lumbuck family not on the board. Rusty Fuller family got 45. Well, don't go away. We'll be right back. Got a long way to go. We're playing Family Feud, everybody. Welcome back to Family Feud, everybody. Lumbuck family not on the board. Rusty Fuller family got 45.
Yeah.
Give me Sophia, give me Tato. Is it Sophia?
It's Sophia.
Got it, Tato.
Tato.
All right, ladies, top seven answers are on the board. Name something people squeeze themselves into.
Their clothes.
Their clothes.
Good answer. Good answer.
We're gonna play. Fouad, what do you do for a living?
I manage a medical facility in Vereeniging, south of Johannesburg.
Okay.
I'm not a doctor, but I can operate. And obviously, my second job is I'm a husband to my lovely wife.
Yes.
And I'm a father of four.
That's a big job. Well, introduce your family.
So first, we've got my lovely wife, Sophia.
Yeah.
Then it's my father-in-law, Ahmed, my sister-in-law, Layla, and my brother-in-law, Shahid.
So this is your father-in-law?
Yes,
this is your wife, mm-hmm. father-in-law, mm-hmm. sister-in-law, mm-hmm. brother-in-law. Mm-hmm. You ain't want to bring none of your family on?
He's the outlaw.
I'm the outlaw.
Oh, they're the outlaw?
I'm the outlaw, they're the in-law.
Oh, you the outlaw.
Yes.
Yeah, okay. Well, that's fair, though. Sophia, what do you do?
I'm a speech therapist. Do you? not the regular kind. I don't work with kids. I have a very interesting job, which I love. I work at a rehab, and I work with patients that have had head injuries and strokes and help them to communicate after that.
Oh, okay. That's good. Spend a lot of time with speech therapists. Because I used to stutter.
I read.
Teachers used to tell me all the time, you're never going to be nothing. You stutter. Hey, yeah. How about now? Yes. Yes, sir. Mr. Ahmed.
Nice to meet you, Steve.
How are you, sir?
Always a pleasure. It's not often that I have to look up to somebody with my height.
Yeah, so but what really are you, about 6 feet tall?
Yeah, it's just a pleasure, you know, it's nice.
6'2", that's nine. That's 9 years. All right, let's play. Name something people squeeze themselves into.
Say, their shoes.
Into their shoes. Layla?
Yep.
What do you do?
I have a very stressful job. I work in a medical aid.
All right. You married?
Yep.
Okay. Two.
Two. My husband is at home, Sulaiman. Sulaiman.
Oh, that's his name?
Yeah.
Oh, I thought you said... Don't even worry about what I thought you said. Name something people squeeze themselves into.
I'm gonna say their car.
Their car!
Yes, Layla, yes, that's a good answer.
Only one strike. Shahid.
Steve.
How you doing, man?
Good and you, my man.
Good, good, good. What do you do?
I'm in the fuel, retail, and convenience industry.
So, fuel?
Yes.
Oh, fuel retail.
So
You got a gas station.
Yes, that's
yeah,
it.
Yeah, that's what that is.
We don't say gas.
I mean, the fuel, retail, and convenience.
We don't say gas in South Africa. When we say gas, we're talking about different gas. Yes,
yes, yes. Yeah.
It's a gas station.
No.
Okay, what do you call it? A patrol station?
Petrol.
Yes. Petrol. That's yeah. it.
Petrol station?
Yeah.
Okay, all right, that's fair. Petrol station. All right, let's go. Name something people squeeze themselves into.
I'm gonna go with a parking spot.
Oh, yes. A parking spot. That was a good answer, though. I liked it. Fouad, name something. You gotta be careful. We got two strikes. The other family can steal. Name something people squeeze themselves into.
Their underwear.
Squeeze themselves into their underwear. Here we go. Name something people squeeze themselves into.
A muscle shirt.
Yes! Yes. Good answer. Good answer. Good
answer. A muscle shirt. Number 7.
Jews.
6.
Arizona.
5.
Box.
4.
Swimsuits.
They were telling me, all of them kept saying, swimsuit, swimsuit, swimsuit. I heard them, and you ignored them. You said, shut up, I'm the captain. You're not telling me what to say. I heard them say swimsuit, 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 muscle shirt.
Okay.
I heard all of them say swimsuit. They said it a bunch of times. I thought it was a great answer. Number 2.
Taxi.
Well, that's round 2, everybody. Lombard family on the board with 48. Russofello family got 45. We got a game now, folks. It's playing Feud. Don't go away. Points are gonna be doubled. Ha! We playing Family Feud in South Africa, man. I told you. I told you. Welcome back to Family Feud, everybody. The Lombard family got 48. The Russofello family got 45. Give me Ahmed, give me Kamu. All right, guys, we got the top 6 answers on the board. Name a reason how you can tell someone smokes in secret.
By smell.
You the smell, the yes. The smell.
How their car smells.
How their car smells.
Are we playing?
We're gonna play.
All right, let's go, Amir.
We're gonna play, see?
Yes.
Layla, name a reason how you could tell someone smokes in secret.
You find the cigarette butts.
You find the cigarette butts.
Yes.
That was a good answer. Shahid, name a reason how you could tell someone smokes in secret.
I'm gonna go with always carry a breath freshener.
They always carry a breath freshener.
Yeah. Yeah.
Fouad, name a reason how you can tell someone smokes in secret.
They always use perfume.
They always use perfume. Sophia, 2 strikes, gotta be careful.
Okay.
Other family can steal. Give me a reason how you could tell someone smokes in secret.
You'd find the empty cigarette boxes.
Empty cigarette boxes.
Good answer, good answer. Yeah.
Nighttime, 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 nighttime. matches.
Cut off the teeth. Lighter.
Lighter?
Lighter.
Or matches?
They carry matches. A lighter.
Lighter.
Cut off the teeth.
They
color
carry
of the
a
teeth.
Lighter.
Carry a lighter. Everywhere. Lighter. Everywhere.
Color of
matches.
The teeth.
Lighter. I repeat. I repeat.
Name. Name a reason that you could tell someone smokes in secret.
Steve, I'm gonna say they carry a lighter with them everywhere.
They carry a lighter! Girl, if you'd have said anything other than that and the color of your teeth, Tato said, I'm not going to say it again. I'm only going to say it one more time. We get home, I am beating you. The color of your teeth. The color of your teeth. Number three.
Boy is hiding.
Two.
Smoke and stop.
Number one. Well, that was round three, everybody. Lombard family got 48. Rushafala family got 79. Well, we still battling. It's a close game, everybody. Don't go away. After the break, we're gonna be playing for double the points. Welcome back to Family Feud, everybody. We got a good game. We got two good families. The Lombard family got 48. The Rushafala family got 79. Give me Layla, give me Gugu, yeah. Gugu. Okay, go all the way around. Ladies, how y'all doing today?
We good. Good.
We good. Let's make it happen. Top six answers are on the board. Surveyed 100 people. Name someone you feel guilty lying to.
My mother.
Your mother. Your mother. Pass or play?
We are definitely playing.
Playing, yes. Now, ladies, I just want to remind you something. You know, just a question ago, the question was, name something that women lie about. You just couldn't come up with it. Well, we back again. Let's just find out someone you feel guilty lying to, because you all do lie. Huh? Hello? Got quiet in here. Tamilo. Name someone you would feel guilty lying to.
Steve, that's a fact. I feel guilty lying to my wife.
Yeah. That's a good answer. That's a good answer.
Let me ask you a question. Have you ever had to lie to your wife?
Yes, Steve.
Yes. You felt bad about it?
Very bad about it.
Yes, but you did it anyway?
Yes, yeah, Steve, I felt really bad about it.
Yeah, but now let's tell the truth. If you had told her the truth, would it have been worse?
I would have been 6 feet under now. That's what I think. Oh, man.
See, women always say, I want to know the truth. No, you don't. Not this truth.
No.
Some other truth.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
The remix.
Do you have decay on your tooth? Yeah, you need to know that. Yeah. Yeah. The rest of it, you don't need to know. Your wife!
Yes.
But now watch this. This is where it's gonna get good right here. These are the professionals. Women are professional liars. You are better at it than men. Name someone you would feel guilty lying to.
My boss.
Yes.
Your boss? What? I ain't gonna feel guilty lying to my boss. I lie right to his face. Your boss. Tato.
Hi, Steve.
Hey, girl. Name someone you would feel guilty lying to.
Your kids.
Yeah. What? My kids.
Yes.
I lie to my kids all the time. All the time. Daddy, do you love me? Yep. Guilty lying to your children. Only one strike. Come on. Is this your turn?
Yep.
Okay. Let's see what you're gonna lie about this time. Name someone you would feel guilty lying to.
My girlfriend or boyfriend.
Your girlfriend or boyfriend? Google, name someone you would feel guilty lying to.
My pastor.
Yes, yes, yes. Your pastor. Yes. The pastor.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Two Melo, two strikes. We gotta be careful. The Lombard family can steal. Name someone you would feel guilty lying to.
Steve, I have to go with my in-laws.
My in-laws. All right, here's your chance. It's a close game. Name someone you would feel guilty lying to.
My doctor.
Your doctor? You lied to your doctor?
Yes.
Oh, you gonna die. Lie to your doctor. What are you lying to your doctor for? Number four.
Friends.
All right, everybody, in this last round, listen to me closely. All of you have everything to play for. In this round right here, whoever gets the most points is going to win this game. It's as simple as that. It's as simple as that. And whoever wins this game is going to have a chance to play for the jackpot, 75,000 Rand. As it stands, the Lombard family, 192.
Yeah.
The Restofalo family, 79. Let's see who's gonna win it. Give me Saheed, give me Tumelo. In this round, point values are triple. Surveyed 100 people, got top five answers on the board. This is what's called a very African question. Obviously, it's something on here I've never heard of, never seen, have no idea what it means. Here I go. Name something you eat with fat cook.
Munts.
What?
Munts. Munts. Munts meat.
Mus.
Yeah! Yeah! We got a plan! We got
a plan! Yeah, I don't know what the hell's going on. Okay, let's go. Okay. Something you eat with fat cook. I'm gonna figure this out. I don't want you to help me. Based on what you say, I'm gonna find out by logic deduction what this is. because I have no idea what fat cook is. Never heard of it. I don't know why you would eat it. I don't know if it's a sauce. I don't know if it's, but I don't know what it is, but I'm fitting to find out by determining what you eat with it. Fuad, name something you eat with fat cook.
Chips.
Chips. Okay, now, chips in over in South Africa is French fries.
Yes.
Okay, cool. Chips! How I'm gonna figure it out if you giving me the boomer? French fries with fat cook. Chips and minced meat. Something you eat with fat talk. Bread. It's bread. Oh, shut up. Sophia, here we go. One strike. Name something you eat with fat cook.
You might know this one, Steve. Acha.
Yes!
Yeah! Yeah! Acha. Acha's mangoes chopped up with different spices and herbs. Yeah. I like acha. I like that. Acha is good. Acha!
Yeah!
Yes, yes,
yes. Chips, acha, minced meat. Ahmed, only one strike. Name something you eat with fat cook.
Steve, I think steak will go nice with it.
Yes.
Steak!
Ah.
You eat chips with it, acha with it, minced meat with it. He wanna put some steak with it. Is it a vegetable? What the hell are you laughing at, though? Okay. We got two strikes. You have to be careful. The other family can steal. Name something you eat with fat cook.
I know a lot of people have it with jam.
Yeah.
It's there.
What? What are y'all eating? The hell would you have some jams with something with some French fries on it? Why would you jam? It's a major argument going on over here. Hello, don't fish con black dog. Good morning, Glenny. Fish con black dog. Say it again. All right, family, I want you to hear something. You'll gain 168 points. You would win the game. If it's there, three answers left on the board. If you guess either one of those three answers, your family wins the game. If you miss it, if it's not there, the Lombard family wins the game. We are looking for an item here in a dish that I've never heard of. It makes no sense to me. This must be on the same level as bong chow.
Yes.
It has to be.
You correct.
Something on the level of quarter.
Yes.
Something is in here and it's all together. So now I've learned a new one, Fet Cook.
Yes.
I need the answer for the win and your chance to play for 75,000 rand. Name something you eat with Fet Cook.
Paloni.
It's paloni, Steve.
It's... for the win, paloni! Number five. I heard fish too. Number four. Man. Man, y'all played really well. You have nothing to be ashamed of. You all played the game really well. And you look good on TV. Well, but you 192 points. So you're taking away 9,600 rand. And KFC for a whole year worth 10,000 rand, so your family can share Kentucky Fried Chicken for a whole year. Really good job, man. Great job. All right, I need two of you. Fast money, I need two of you. All right, I got Refill Way and I got Google. We're gonna play Fast Money. Jackpot, 75,000 rand. Come on, let's go. Welcome back to the Feud, everybody. The Russafola family won the game. And now it's time to play... All right, this is how Fast Money works. Refill Way, Gugu is off stage. She can't see or hear your answers. I'm gonna ask you five questions in 20 seconds. Try to give me the most popular answers. If you can't think of something, you just say pass, and I'll get back to it if we have enough time. If you and Gugu together come up with 200 points, look right there, tell everybody what you're gonna win.
Win 75,000 rand.
75,000 rand.
Yeah.
You ready?
Yeah.
20 seconds on the clock, please. Clock will start after I read the first question. Name a job where you need to be good with numbers.
Accounting.
A comfort food people eat.
Coffee.
Another word for amazing.
Brilliant.
A place you clean using a ladder.
Windows.
Something you might see on New Year's Eve.
Fireworks.
All right, darling, let's see how we did. Name a job where you need to be good with numbers. You said... accounting. Survey said...
yes.
A comfort food people eat. You said... nothing like biting down on a nice piece of coffee. Survey said... another word for amazing. You said... brilliant. Survey said? A place you clean using a ladder, you said? The window, survey said? Something you might see on New Year's Eve, you said? Fireworks, survey said? Oh yeah, there we go, that's good. All right, Google, let's clear the board. Bring out Google. Well, Gugu, your sister?
Aunt.
Aunt, yes, right, your aunt. She's married to your son.
If she got the right answers, she's still my aunt.
Oh.
If not, I think when the courts open, we'll go and file for divorce as a family.
Wow. Well, welcome to Family Feud. Okay, well, let me tell you this. She did almost exactly half. She got 103.
103.
Yeah. 103. You need 97.
All right.
Okay, it's tougher in the second position because it's just a lot of answers have been given.
Okay.
But this is how it works. I'm gonna ask you the same five questions. You cannot duplicate her answers. If you do, you're gonna hear this sound. I'll say try again, you give me another answer. It's gonna be a little bit tougher this time, so we'll give you 25 seconds. You ready?
I'm ready.
All right, let's remind everybody of let's remind everybody of the other lady's answers. Tired of trying to come up with these. Refilwe. Yeah. 25 seconds on the clock, please. Clock will start after I read the first question. Name a job where you need to be good with numbers.
Accountant.
Try again.
Engineer.
A comfort food people eat.
Slop chips.
Another word for amazing.
Outstanding.
A place you clean using a ladder.
A ladder, gutters.
Something you might see on New Year's Eve.
Braai, smoke.
All right, let's go. All right, Google, let's go. All right, let's see how we did. Name a job. Oh, well, you need 97 points. Let's go. Name a job where you need to be good with numbers. You said engineer. Survey said accountant was the number one answer. Accounting. You need 87. A comfort food people eat. You said slap chips. Survey said okay. Ice cream was the number one answer. My favorite food in the world, ice cream. We need 76 points, come on. Another word for amazing, you said outstanding. Survey said? Number one answer, wow. 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 Hey, we asked y'all these questions. These your people. Mzanzi, that's you. A place you clean using a ladder, you said. The gutters, survey said. Oh, that was a good answer. Roof, the roof was number one. Roof. I thought that was a good answer. We need a big one. Something you might see on New Year's Eve, you said. The bride, survey said. Fireworks. Fireworks was number one.
Wow.
Well, but we're gonna triple your points. You guys are gonna walk away with 32,150 rand. I'm Steve Harvey. We'll see you next time, folks. Man, I wanted y'all to win that money. Hope y'all had a good time. I want y'all to win that money.